All right, back at this American Standard furnace. So last week, we didn't have the right amount of voltage coming out of that bad boy right there. Only had 12 volts, if I was lucky. Put this bad boy in right here. Let's get the show on the road. All right. These bad boys never want to cooperate. One more, huh? Get out. Spare myself the embarrassment. Beautiful. I think this will look nicer than the Wago. Beautiful. That's transformer neutral. Let's put that bad boy right there. Beautiful. Let's repeat that process with transformer line in. Same thing. Just clean this up. Makes it look so much nicer and cleaner. All right. Here is line voltage coming into my door switch, leaving the door switch, going to my board. Line voltage in, transformer line voltage, transformer neutral, and line voltage neutral. Hooked up to my voltmeter. Let's do a little test. See that? Only 21 volts right there. Interesting. Now I got the line voltage not going to the door switch, but going right to the control board, then to my transformer. Let's see what we get. Still the same 21 volts. Ain't the door switch, folks. All right, control board. Furnace wiring is all connected. Here's my low voltage safety circuit. Our inducer assembly and hot surface igniter, fan control. Let's give her some power. All right, so far so good. Just a steady flash. All right. Now, we're going to do a quick test on that contactor. 16, 15. Good. This is C and Y that go to that contactor in the outdoor unit. Come on, go in there. Why don't you want to go in? Go in. There you go. Sweet. Alright, I connected everything, and then as soon as waiting for equipment at the thermostat was over, the thermostat went blank, but we're still flashing there, and our fuse did not blow, and we're not drawing any current or any amperage on R. Maybe, let's just put it on there. Nothing there. All right, let's see. want to see what happens when that thermostat goes blank. And I wonder if it's wiring. Why are you so long and annoying?
I hate that thermostat.
Is it really a 5-minute delay?
Still says it?
Still says it, right?
Yeah.
That's an awfully long delay.
Okay.
Almost 5 minutes.
Wow, is that good or bad?
Well, normally I don't normally see him take that long to turn on.
Okay.
Waiting for equipment is thermostat.
Gotcha. Yeah.
And before, when we were waiting for it, it just went blank, and I thought maybe something else happened down here, but it's fine. Okay. This is obscene.
Waiting for equipment. All right, let's do a little jumparoo here. Let's do G to R. Let's see what's going on here with this amperage. Nope. Nothing there either, huh? Wow. That's crazy. That's a park. That's a park. That's high. That's a neutral. Let's try something here. Let's see something here. Let's try. One there enough. I want to check it somewhere else. Yeah, check this out, folks. Let's see. 28 volts. See that? That's crazy. Circuit's bad. Unbelievable. All right, everything is reconnected. Thermostat. It is what it is. Y and C going to a contactor. I created a pigtail here. I can plug an extension cord into that. And let's get all this in there. This. Come on, baby. Back on there like that. We'll get a screw in there. Oh, there's the screw. Perfect. Absolutely ridiculous. Circuit sheds load when there's load applied. All right, outdoor unit is running. Okay, system off, done. And let's make sure the fan turns off. All right, now we're waiting for fan to turn off. Unbelievable.
You know what? They say there's a first time for everything. And in all the years, all my professional years doing HVAC, I never ran into that problem before. We had 122 volts. When any kind of load was applied to it, even the transformer, it started to drop out. It's crazy. However, the moral of the story here is, folks, never give up. Don't throw in the towel prematurely. Where there's a will, there's a way. I'm going to be very blunt here. Did thoughts of selling them a new furnace enter my mind? Absolutely. And then I was thinking, like, what happens when I put the new furnace in and the same exact thing happens to this? Like, the common denominator here is power. We need to investigate power. I created a pigtail. I wired that in. I made sure that my line, L1 and neutral, polarity was okay. Because the polarity is reversed, the fan's going to run continuously like it was doing when I first plugged it in. Right? It's getting power on neutral and it's running continuously. I did my due diligence. I left no stone unturned and we got the system to run and operate the way it was designed to. If you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, look no further than Pipe Doctor Home Services for any commercial or residential issue. Whether it's a rooftop unit on your building, a ductless mini split system in your basement, or a central HVAC system, trust Pipe Doctor to get rid of the problem because we believe there are no problems, only solutions. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you got something out of it, I did, that's for sure. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Hit that thumbs up button, folks. And subscribe if you haven't done so already. I would really appreciate it. It's the best way that you can support this channel. Thank you again, folks. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe. Enjoy your Labor Day.